Please feel free to have a seat while they last. We thank you all for coming. I'm Joe Paul. I'm Vice President for Student Affairs, and I'm very happy to welcome you one and all to this really historic day in the history of the university. This Century Park South project, and we asked them, we're on such a tight timeline, we asked them not even to stop for the ceremony. So you hear that buzz of activity back there. It's not only going to be transformative for this north part of the campus, but also really significant in helping us to recruit, retain, and graduate the very best students in the Gulf South. This is the largest by square footage and dollar amount construction project in the history of the university. The three buildings will house the Moffitt Health Center, the Lucky Day Scholars Program, and will provide housing for over 950 students when most of it opens in the fall of 2014. I want to thank you all for being here today. Others will be thanked at various times, but I really want to especially thank my team in Student Affairs who've been so engaged in this. Sid Gomslin, our Associate Vice President for Auxiliaries, who's a master at planning these kinds of facilities. Dr. Scott Blackwell, our Director of Residence Life, who you will hear from later. Dr. Larry Sparkman, who runs our Lucky Day program. Dr. Virginia Crawford, for her generosity and her vision, and many, many others. I want to also point out Dr. Chris Crenshaw, who when we began envisioning this program was Director of Residence Life, is now Director of Physical Plant and is able to see it come out of the ground. And this is a complex, has been a complex project from a financing standpoint. There are private dollars through generous gifts, there's bonding involved, and a real unsung hero in this that really stayed with it and helped us put it together is Miss Allison Easterwood, our controller. So let's give her and all of those our applause. I now ask Dr. Scott Blackwell to come forward and offer an invocation.
O eternal God, bless all schools, colleges, and universities, and especially the University of Southern Mississippi, that they may be lively centers for sound learning, new discovery, and the pursuit of wisdom. And grant that those who teach and those who learn may find you to be the source of all truth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please join me in welcoming President Rodney Bennett to the podium.
Good morning, everybody. We are grateful today for so many things, but particularly for these beautiful trees that are providing some much needed shade on this occasion. So I'm grateful for that. I want to thank everybody for being with us today. What an exciting time for the University of Southern Mississippi to be able to break ground on 954 new beds for students. This project really illustrates the university's commitment to providing the best living learning environment possible for our students. And it will serve most certainly as a symbol of the progress and excellence that defines USM. In addition to these beautiful trees that are providing shade to us this morning, we're also grateful to the IHL board for approving this project. It would definitely not be possible without the support, longtime support, of the Lucky Day Foundation, which has been a partner for USM for many, many years and contributed more than $4 million of support to our institution. And then what would today be without Dr. Virginia Moffitt Crawford and her family, and the generous contributions that they provide to the University of Southern Mississippi. Dr. Crawford, we thank you for your support and service. One of my goals as president is to create an educational experience for students that will support their progression towards graduation. And a state-of-the-art student housing complex like Century Park South will certainly enhance those efforts. Research has shown that a positive residential experience has great impact on helping students achieve success both academically and as they grow and develop on their path towards graduation. For many of us who live on campus or who lived on campus during our own college experiences, know that time in the residence hall provided so many memories for that period in our lives and fostered the development of lifelong friendships with our hallmates. Those memories have helped us stay connected to the institution as alumni, and those friendships have stayed with us long term. I am delighted that we are now building a new place for our students at Southern Miss where they too can develop those types of lifelong connections, both with our institution and with each other. Thank you all for joining us this morning to share in this groundbreaking ceremony and in support of student success at the University of Southern Mississippi.
A college housing colleague once joked that it's easier to build a new residence hall than it is to kill all the bugs in an old residence hall. Well, both of these things are difficult to do. There's nothing easy about building anything on a college campus, but we're going to get this project done. Century Park South will stand as testimony to the University of Southern Mississippi's commitment to providing the very best for our students. Century Park South will include the Moffitt Health Center, the Lucky Day Citizenship Hall, 19 student kitchen lounges, 24 study rooms, private bathrooms for students, staff offices, 27 RAs, and 954 bed spaces comprised of 457 double rooms and 40 single rooms. Century Park South is important to the university because it will serve as replacement housing for residence halls that were built in the 1950s and 1960s and will serve freshmen men and women as well as non-freshman students. It will be a wonderful addition to a college student housing inventory that already offers variety and choices for our students. It will be the place to live on campus, and I'm seriously considering moving my family to Century Park South. Next, I'd like to welcome to the podium Mr. Bob Pierce, Vice President for University Advancement.
Thank you, Scott. And again, to everyone here assembled, thank you for taking the time to join us for this historic and important occasion. This is indeed a special day, and we are proud that you are here to share it with us. I'm honored to have this opportunity to address you, primarily because of what my involvement in this ceremony represents, and that is the role that private charitable contributions played in making today a reality. However, before I speak on that subject, I'm compelled to recognize a few individuals, and I appreciate your indulgence while I do so. Some of these were already mentioned by Dr. Paul, but they merit being mentioned again. You've already heard from our distinguished president, Dr. Rodney Bennett, and our obviously dedicated director of residence life, Dr. Scott Blackwell. There's no doubt that without the leadership of these two men, we would not be breaking ground today on an incredible and important facility, one that will make a tremendous impact on Southern Miss. I thank them both for their service and for their leadership. In addition, having been around here for almost 15 years, I sometimes feel like an old timer. Now that may seem a little odd, 15 years is not that long, but having been here, you know, you've seen a lot and you've experienced a lot. And that viewpoint of an old timer gives one perspective on how much effort has to be invested in a vision to make projects like this one come to fruition. So first, I want to mention a few people. First, Dr. Joe Paul. Joe, why don't you stand up and come around here where people can actually see you. Joe, I congratulate you on all that you've accomplished at Southern Miss and particularly on the journey that led to this groundbreaking. Not only were you a critical component in developing the relationship with the Lucky Day Foundation and establishing the Lucky Day Citizenship Scholars Program more than a decade ago, and not only did you work with Holmes Adams and the Lucky Day Foundation Board of Managers to secure the private gift for Lucky Day Citizenship Hall, you also fought the good fight in a tight university budget environment to ensure these facilities became a reality. Thank you for your dedication to Southern Miss. Where's Dr. Crenshaw? Chris, step forward just a little bit. You don't have to come up on stage.
Come on up here.
Step lively. By the time I finish reading his title, he may have made it up here. Chris is our Assistant Vice President for Facilities Management and Planning and Director of the Physical Plant. And as Joe mentioned, Chris and the physical plant staff will now be responsible for overseeing the construction of this complex. But I can still remember him calling me over to his office when he was the Director of Residence Life to show me the concept for the expansion of Century Park. And it wasn't long after Century Park North was finished, or it might have even still been under construction. Chris, it was an impressive facility then, and it's an impressive facility now. Congratulations on getting us here. Now, Dr. Jenny Crawford, I'll get to you in a moment. I could certainly group you in with these other long-timers, complimenting your vision and commitment. However, since you decided to also put your money where your mouth is, I'll get back to you. Finally, and again, you've already heard some of these names, I think we need to recognize as a group some additional current and former university staffers for their respective roles in helping get this project off the ground. They include Larry Sparkman, Sid Gonsolin, Doug Vinzant, Allison Easterwood, Chad Driscoll, Russ Willis, Martha Saunders, Joe Morgan, Connie Morgan, David Bounds, and the staffs of Residence Life, Physical Plant, Student Affairs, the Lucky Day Citizenship Scholars Program, Student Health Services, and the Division of Finance and Administration. Congratulations to this group, and let's give them a round of applause. Okay, now to why I'm actually here. You already know that this is an approximately $55 million project. However, you also need to know that without the $5 million in investment in the project by private donors, we would not be here today. Dr. Paul and others can confirm that because of the significant price tag of Century Park South, coupled with the rapid expansion of facilities the university has experienced in the last decade, we became uncertain whether the university could afford to proceed with Century Park South. That was when the Board of Managers of the Lucky Day Foundation stepped forward with its $4 million gift commitment to push the project forward and name one of the facilities being constructed behind you Lucky Day Citizenship Hall. The hall will serve as the home for the Lucky Day Citizenship Scholars Program and for Larry Sparkman, and will be a fitting location for the most successful privately funded scholarship program the university has ever seen. The Lucky Day Foundation is also the most generous benefactor in the history of the university, with more than $20 million committed to support our facilities and our programs. As I call their names, I ask that the members of the Lucky Day Foundation Board of Managers please rise. Holmes Adams, Chairman, Barbara Day, Jerry Host, Jamie Houston, Griffin Norquist, and the Foundation's Executive Director, Pat Smith. To each of you, thank you for your unwavering commitment to the University of Southern Mississippi. I'm confident Mr. Day is smiling down and enjoying this moment. Let's give them a round of applause. And now back to Dr. Crawford. I can tell you she absolutely loves this attention. Are you having fun? You having a good time? In a similar situation to the residence hall aspect of Century Park South, the university has been in desperate need of a new health services facility for years. Jenny has championed the construction of a new clinic for a long time. However, it was not until the idea was conceived to incorporate the clinic into the residence hall project, and Jenny and her family made a significant gift commitment that the prospects of the Moffitt Health Center became a reality. By the time the center is complete, more than $1 million in private funds will have been expended on it. A list of those donors who have already committed $1,000 or more to the Moffitt Health Center campaign is on the back of your program. Jenny, you've been dedicated to this university for decades in numerous ways, and it warms my heart to see that your vision is finally taking shape. I know you have waited for this day to come, and I hope you enjoy it. Without you and your family, the Moffitt Health Center could not happen. Let's give Jenny and her family a round of applause. Without question, the role of private giving to support Southern Miss is becoming more and more vital to the growth and strengthening of our programs. To everyone here today who's participated in helping make us better by offering charitable contributions to the USM Foundation, I thank you for playing a role in taking Southern Miss
to the top.
Thank you. You will now hear from our two most significant benefactors for Century Park South. First, Mr. Holmes Adams. Mr. Adams is a partner in the law firm of Adams & Reese in Jackson, and as previously acknowledged, is the chairman of the Lucky Foundation Board of Managers. He will then be followed by Dr. Virginia Crawford, director of the University Student Health Services and lead donor to the Moffitt Health Center. Please join me in welcoming first Mr. Adams and then Dr. Crawford.
Thank you, Appreciate it. President Bennett, honored guest, and by honored guest, I mean every one of you who have honored us with your presence this morning. We are delighted to see you and wish you a good morning. I speak this morning in a representative capacity. That means I don't speak just for myself, but for other people. And first, I dare to presume to speak for Frank Day. It was Frank Rogers Day's vision for this scholarship program and the establishment of the Lucky Day Foundation that made this scholarship program and ultimately this building possible. And Barbara and I have long discussed that we think he would be very pleased with everything that's going on here at Southern Miss. Next, I speak for all of the members of the Board of Managers of the Lucky Day Foundation and our Executive Director. Every one of them is present here today, and we intend that to send a strong signal to USM and to everyone else in the academic community of our continued support and commitment to this program and to this university. Next, we would like to offer our heartfelt thanks to you, Dr. Bennett, for your continued support of the program, and also to your predecessors, to Shelby Timms, to Martha Saunders, and to Aubrey Lucas, who have worked so hard to assist this program in establishing it in its very beginning stage. And above all, we thank Larry Sparkman. Dr. Sparkman has simply ignited this program, and he has guided our foundation in making decisions about it that we were uneducated to do without his advice and counsel. And finally, we thank everybody here at the university who have contributed their time and efforts to the program and the students. To make a poor paraphrase, it almost takes a whole university to make a program like this function well. Now, I would really like to spend my time addressing my remarks to the Lucky Day students and to all of the students here at the university. For 10 years now, you students have upheld your end of the bargain with this foundation. Using objective standards of measurement, you have the best retention rate of any other group on this campus. Using objective standards of measurement, you have the best graduation rate of any other group on this campus. You have set the bar academically very high for yourselves, and we have been delighted with your work. More importantly, however, I think you have also set a standard for servant leadership at this university and in this community that, frankly, we didn't expect to come out of this program in the magnitude that it has. It has simply been amazing. And the program itself has become a model for other universities and for other foundations across the United States when they look toward the success of the program. Because of you students, really, the foundation was inspired to assist in constructing these buildings, and we trust that they will provide you a place where you can continue your academic studies and a community where mature ideals of good citizenship may continue to grow. Now, I'd like to speak for a few moments just for myself, and I really would like to address a larger audience than all of you gathered here today. In these days and times, public universities need financial assistance if they're going to advance and improve their programs and the quality of education they offer students. I can tell you from 10 years of work at USM that Southern Miss makes wise and frugal use of every dollar that they are given. And I encourage everyone who is considering a gift to help a student with a scholarship or to help student life in any other way to step up to the plate and join Dr. Crawford and the Lucky Day Foundation in continuing to make this place a very strong university. So make those gifts for them. Thank you very much.
Good morning. Just like any college student worth their salt, I waited until last night to develop my remarks. And because I really wanted to call in sick, because this is not something I enjoy doing, I went by the clinic and got an excuse. And I thought Bob would absolutely die if I did that. So I have a few remarks, and it got a little longer than I had intended, so please bear with me. First of all, students are the focus of this project. In the planning process, it was clear that our student health service staff wanted to create a facility that meets the current and future needs of students. The new Moffitt Health Center will be an efficient space with lab, x-ray, pharmacy, as well as a wing for health promotion. We will be adding dental services, which are at the request of students. Additionally, this design of the facility needed to be welcoming, safe, and confidential. I think that Justin and Tom with the McCarty Architect Group have developed those qualities for us. When this project started, we gave them a 19-page list of requirements, wishes, in small font, and they have been very successful at ticking off nearly all of the boxes, and those that didn't get ticked off, they said why they shouldn't be, and they were right. The staff of the Student Health Service loves students, so much so that 100% of the staff contributed financially to this project. Y'all can recognize them. They have on black scrubs. Thank you. That's huge, really huge. I, as a staff member in the Division of Student Affairs, have been very committed to making things better for students and have known that students needed a better Student Health Service facility since the day I walked in the door. And that was 24 years ago. I've tried to tag a new health center on every building project on campus for the last 24 years. And this is the right one. The last one is the right one. It has been great fun working with residence halls and with Lucky Day to develop a great program. Now, why Moffitt Health Center? I want to let you know about the Moffitts. I come from a family of physicians. The Moffitts, my maiden name, my mother, Nina, was a psychiatrist. That's why I'm weird. My dad, Ellis, was an allergist, and my brother, John, a pediatric allergist. They were all very successful, respected individually and collectively, and have done a lot for healthcare in the state of Mississippi. My mother died of breast cancer in 1998. My dad had not planned on the love of his life dying before him, and therefore he was in a position to make a charitable contribution. I asked him if he would make the gift to Southern Miss for a new facility, and with minimal groveling and begging on my part, he agreed. Therefore, he is the lead donor for the new facility. My dad died in 2004, and my brother and only sibling died in 2007. My brother's wife, Jenny, has been very generous to the Moffitt Student Health Service. The lobby will be named after my brother, who was really smart. So smart that he married Jenny. He was smart in lots of other ways too, but one of his greatest things was marrying Jenny. I miss my family greatly and think that they would be honored to have this facility named after them. I am a richly blessed person. I have a great family, and I married into a great family. Howell, my husband of 30 years, came in late to physiology class in our first year of medical school and was stuck sitting next to me, and the rest is history. If you ask him, he says he planned to sit by me. The truth is, he was playing ping pong in the student lounge and was almost late and had to sit next to me. But anyhow, as fate would have it, it has worked out. We love Southern Miss. He has been nothing but supportive of this idea I've had for a new student help service and has listened to me try to put it in the business building and every other building. Not only has he been supportive, but my mother-in-law, Frances Crawford, has been very generous. One of the rooms in the new facility is going to be named after Howell's dad, who is a very accomplished surgeon in Tylertown, Dr. Everett Crawford. Yes, my family has been instrumental in this project, but so has my work family and many of my dear friends. The list is extensive, so bear with me. I have to mention Connie and Joe Morgan, and Cindy and Tim Hilt and the Parker family. Connie, Cindy, and I have worked together for 24 years, and we have a shared passion for providing quality health care for students. There are many others who have been generous in making the health care for students better in the future. Thanks to Michael and Christine Hammett for their gift in honor of Dr. Larry Hammett, Alan and Melinda Lucas, Hal and Lisa McMahon, Joe and Meg Paul. He would do anything to shut me up. Greg and Kathy Owen, Melissa and Paul Roberts, Robin and Chris Schwartz, Kathy and Clint White, Russ Willis, Vivian Carver, Dolly Lloyd, Celeste Tisdale, Michael Chancellor, Heather Nelson, and many others. There are many people that have contributed in other ways besides financially. Thanks to Chris Crenshaw and David Bounds, y'all probably kept me out of a lot of trouble. And all the folks at McCarty Architect Group and their subcontractors. I need to give a special thanks to Sid Gonsolin, with whom I share a vision for creation of a wellness culture on our campus. Sid has helped make this happen. Well, he hasn't given up, even when I did. I also need to thank Bob Pierce and Allison Easterwood, who has explained a very difficult performa to me, and to Joe Paul for putting up with me. The new facility really is just the beginning for implementation of new services, such as dental and expansion of health promotion and education, nutrition services, and to add telehealth for our satellite campuses and provide after-hours care. Thank you so much for being here as part of this celebration. Southern Miss, to the top.
Thank you to Holmes Adams, to the Lucky Day Board of Managers, to the entire Crawford family. And Hal, I'm glad you were totally supportive, but being married to Jenny, I don't know that you really had a lot of choice about that. But we appreciate you all very, very much. We're going to do this groundbreaking now. We've got so many people to acknowledge that we're going to do it in two sets. The first will be the platform party, joined by the Board of Managers of the Lucky Day Foundation. And the second group will be our partners, and I'll acknowledge them when we get to that second groundbreaking, our architects and our consultants and our contractor. So if the podium group, along with Larry Sparkman, Connie Morgan, and the Lucky Day Board members, will move to the side of the sand over here.